is there anybody here who does not want to be successful? For that matter, what is success and what is being successful? Is it having a big car or a huge house or lovely children or large sums of money? Well, maybe. We're no saints after all. At least I'm not a saint. So let's unravel what success really is. For me, each time I thought it can't get any worse, it always got worse. It's almost like as if life heard it and said, challenge accepted. Like most of us, in fact, like all of us, I have been through a lot. Now, most of the things that I went through can be divided into two categories: God-sent problems and man-made problems. Of the man-made problems, there is also another special subset, my self-created problems. Some were the usual ones. I was too dark, I was too fat, I was mocked for my privilege of birth, I was over-clever because I was ambitious, I was less competent as an engineer because I'm a woman, I was judged for just wanting to have a career. However, this one is not a sad story, because I was not the one to get hurt easily or be dissuaded easily. I thrived. I thrived because I was resilient. I had this property of resilience without even knowing that it was called resilience or that it was needed as an essential life skill. Despite that, some of the man-made problems cut deeper. The first one among them is belittling. It started early. I won a gold medal at school, to which one of my aunts concluded and propagated that my school was unimpressive, had few students, and it wasn't a big deal really, because that was the only way of explaining my achievement. The second in the list is ageism, a sort of discrimination that we inflict upon people based on their age. The woman in me would want to stay young forever, but I learned painfully that sometimes the term young can be used for disparaging accomplishment and competence. The third in the list is gaslighting. By the way, thank you, Gen Z, for teaching me that the emotional manipulation in which we at times, you know, we are made to doubt our own perception, our own understanding, and sometimes our sanity is called gaslighting. Despite all this, what kept the fire burning? It was my desire to be successful. Or wait, was it my desire to be happy? Or wait, did I even know the difference? As a teenager, I was very driven. I wanted to be successful. I hustled, I wanted to grow, I wanted to move forward. It was only after years of collecting achievements, of climbing the ladder, of chasing titles, that I paused and I pondered over what success really meant, what it was and what is it that we were all pursuing, or we still are. I learned several things and I realized that success isn't that at some point life comes to a final stage where it all settles down and then we call that state as a successful state. It doesn't work that way. Each time we think we have made it, the boundary moves further ahead. The accomplishments become the new normal, and those accomplishments bring along with itself new challenges. Success is not reaching a certain final stage. It is about walking that path every day. As a married woman who had a daughter, I decided to pursue my doctoral studies abroad. It was not easy. I was told that my marriage won't work. I was told that my child would irreparably suffer. I was told that I was an obnoxious mother. However, I had a tunnel vision, and I knew that my hard work was the only way forward for myself and for my family. In 2013, I was a Pakistani female engineer working on the application of artificial intelligence on Europe's nuclear fusion devices. Success came in the form of scientific knowledge. Success came in the form of the diversity that I was lucky enough to experience and accept. Success came in the form of friends and human beings and seeing their way of life, which was very different from my usual frame of reference, from my comfort zone. Success came in the form of travel, in which I traveled from Japan to North America to South France. And it peaked when I took my children to Disneyland. Nevertheless, again, as I said, I learned several things. I learned that hardships in life aren't always there because they're trying to make things better. They're sometimes there because due to them, things become clearer. I learned that pain removes illusions. Heartbreak exposes the truth. Failure shows what really matters. And it is criticism which tells us who supports us. However, not every criticism is wisdom. Not every failure is final, and not every loud voice in the room is correct. Moving on, sometimes success comes in the form of contribution. However, I learned another thing. Any success is transitionary. Alexander the Great, who conquered half the world, left the same world at the age of 32. The forces of Yazid won at Karbala, but the one who succeeded was Hussein ibn Ali. Because of his integrity, because of his honor. Success, my dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, is fighting battles with grace. Success is clarity. Success is resilience. Success is realizing that if you're underestimated, it is not your fault, it is someone else's limitation. Success is realizing understanding that no one will cherish for you, or they may not cherish you, but you have to cherish your own self. Success is compromising your comfort over growth. Success is passing your days, living your days with integrity, dignity, and grace. It is not where you reach, it is who you become along the way. Thank you.